So being a part of a big event isn't a new thing for you. That's probably even taking stride.
Yeah, that is. Being out of town and out of the country, that's a big difference. You know, I'm very thankful to have, speaking of the trip, to have Angel on board, because, you know, he was able to plan out my whole trip. He said, listen, I want you sleeping from this hour to this hour on the plane, and as soon as you get to this airport, just stay up the whole time. As soon as you get to the hotel, you're going to knock out. You're going to go to sleep. And
Roy Jones Jr.
That's your connection.
I'm not really a smart guy. I just try to do things that work. So for me, if I can get Angel to help him with weight and get him in shape, and then I can help with his boxing psyche, you can't beat him. And that's kind of what happened. So I knew Angel from working with this guy as Jean Pascal, and he did a great job with Pascal. So when he found out I was working with Jesse, Angel called me and said, hey man, ask Jesse, do you need any help? I would love to help him do it. I didn't really know, so I waited. Then I thought about it, saying, you know, if he's saying the weight is an issue for him, maybe I should call him and let him talk to Angel. So I gave Angel his number, I told him I gave Angel his number. They talked, and they helped
him. And do you kind of see Jesse's a rough diamond, but almost an unpolished talent?
Really, if you see him today, he's polished already. He was rough when I met him.
just touching on you, your girlfriend not being able to reach you, which sounds like a wonderful way to have. Unfortunately, Mike can reach me. But obviously, you've got someone like Manny who has like a vast entourage. Floyd, vast entourage. Do you think that really helps a fighter, or does that hurt a fighter? Because you said before you have people probably contacting you about tickets or things they want from you. Surely it's better not to have an entourage and just to be focused, you know, and have that sort of discipline. Or will we see in 2 years' time you with 40 guys going...
Well, I think everyone's different. Everyone has a different personality. I personally like to keep my circle small. I like to keep it within myself and just because it's easier to plan things out that way, and it's easier for you to have a better outlook on things, you know, when you have less distractions. I've always been like that as a kid. My father actually has a big part of that, because as I was growing up, you know, he showed me a lot of things. And to me, I love being on my own. I'm just the normal guy next door. You'll see him. You see him at the store. You'll see me by myself. Every now and then, I like to have lunch by myself. Hanging out, just kind of thinking about what I'm going to do, what's next, whether it's business, the business aspect of it, or just where I'm going to take out my girlfriend. But I like to hang out, just I don't know, I enjoy it sometimes.
Have you noticed people's reaction in Vegas changed you as you become famous? Obviously, more people want to be your friend.
They're surprised
now
that I'm by myself. I'm at the mall by myself, and then, this is Jesse Vargas. What's up? This is me. But, you know, I guess that's something different about me and plenty of other fighters that I just. I like keeping my circle small. You know, I feel that might just be me personally, and not, I guess maybe not too many fighters are like that, but I enjoy it.
That's for sure. Jesse, I'm sure you've played the fight in your head a million times. What do you see when the fight happens in your head between you and DeMarco?
What do I see? I see that big shot landing each time, breaking it apart. Him crumpling with each shot. Yeah, that's what I see. He has no defense for me. I mean, whatever he wants to do, he's going to get hit. You know, and there's going to be a time when he's going to say, come on, and I'm saying, I'm here. Come on. And he's not going to want to step forward. He's just doing it just to make his fans think that he wants to fight.
I know, obviously, you've got the political factions, and you've got two WBA titles, obviously, you and Garcia. Garcia must be a fight that you would love to have.
Definitely. I want to fight the best fighters in my division. I really do. That's my ultimate goal, is to be the pound-for-pound fighter. For that, we have to beat the best. I can easily say that I'm fighting good opposition. I'm fighting some undefeated fighters.